Welcome to the second round of the 102nd Amateur Championship, live from Rivermont in Johns Creek. Justin Connelly, the 2017 champion from Westlake, in my hometown of Augusta.
This is the 102nd Georgia Amateur Championship, round number two. This is the 8-10 tee time. First on the tee, Justin Connelly.
Like yesterday's feature player, Luke Koenig, he shot 3 over 73. Justin got caught in the two weather delays yesterday afternoon for Whiteman. Luke played in the morning. Toughest hole on the course yesterday, averaging 4.8 shots this 455-yard opening hole. And they are finishing up round one at the same time.
Next to play is Robert Five,
the 2014 champion from Idle Hour Club in Macon. Despite making a late triple bogey. This championship goes back to Augusta next year, Augusta Country Club, to be exact. Second shot today to a flag that's on 8 and 6 from the left side. Well, I thought it was his turn. It was actually the keeper's turn. Now Justin. Robert is in the right rough. Only two birdies were recorded here all day yesterday in round one. Scoring average of 4.79. Played more like a par five. Robert's second shot went long and left. Hit a great flop shot to a few feet for his par. Now Justin for birdie. A rare birdie here if he can drop this. Next hole is still playing as a 470-yard par 4. Which I believe was either the third or the fourth hardest hole yesterday. Looks like it's going to be a solid par for Justin. Stays at 3 over. So I think he is 6 over for the championship now. Converted par 4. And we're going left. There's trees over there. a little bit of a wait. Justin Connelly now getting ready to play his approach shot to the par 4 second. Now the left rough. Holes on 25 and 5 and right. Long and right are no good here. Justin here is at the second. And I think Connor Eastart should be playing right behind this group. Haven't seen Connor yet this morning. But Connor McMillan will tee off this afternoon at 12:50. Jonathan Klotz tees off at 12:40. Whoa. That to save par. 1, 2, 4. That was a tough stretch yesterday. Especially 1 and 2. Third might play a little more difficult today. With that back right pin position. May not even have lost his turn. Robert has a birdie putt. Coming up, but from left of the hole, he's got to deal with that ridge. He had found the fairway, Robert did. That didn't even get to the green, that third shot. Connelly here at the second, this for par. He'll have that to drop the shot. Justin for bogey at the second, and Robert just 2 putts for his par. This to drop Connelly to +4. And then off to the third. Justin at the 445-yard par 4 third hole. Broken down the left side. Pound the red trees down the right. Justin's down the left side of the third fairway. Now even with that fairway bunker there, just 3 of late to reach. And today 25 on the 7th on the right side. Don't want to miss right. There's a penalty area over there. Justin onto the green. Be dancing for birdie. Found the fairway and the green here at the third. So he has a putt for birdie. And Justin has a putt for birdie as well. Albeit a long one. He's underneath the hole. Par 3 fourth hole coming up next. Needed a little bit more pace. I was tracking the whole way. That would have been a bounce back birdie after relinquishing the shot on the previous hole to par. Robert would be getting ready to putt for his birdie. He bogeyed the opening hole. Connor Asart should be back there in the fairway, his group, at 820. All right, Connelly for par. My, it's just par. This was just going to stay at plus four for the week. And there is a cut to be made later this evening, weather permitting. Low 60 in ties. The shortened par 3 4th hole, playing 175 today. It was all the way back at 195 yesterday. Roberts on the green. And today, 8 on, 5 from the left. Anything missing left. Good throw down the hill. He's the bunker. There's a tough up and down. Heading right. I think that's in the first of the two bunkers there. Breeze beginning to pick up a little bit in this overcast morning. A few little sprinkles here and there earlier. Let's come up with a nice line at the inside bunker. Green slopes from right to left on the right side. Ooh. Did he get it out? Oh, it's rolled back in. Third shot. Better result that time. And it's left it below the hole, but that would be for bogey. Drops us in the plus five for the week. Should he make that putt? This hole, I believe, was the sixth hardest hole at round one. Big putt here for Connelly at four. This is for bogey. Okay, limits the damage to just one shot. Two over for the day after four. But pretty early in this second round. Now just a 245 yard par 4 fifth hole. Trees on both sides. Bunkers on both sides. Saw Luke Koenig miss the fairway to the right yesterday. Right to the bogey for him. Chip it out sideways, almost backwards. Both of the even numbered holes so far today. That might be going a little left. On the far left side of the fifth fairway, and where the hole location is today, not a particularly good angle for him because it's 23 on and 4 from the left side. Anything missed left could find that greenside bunker, which would be a short-sided miss. If you go a miss, you're better off missing to the right. Pretty calm out here now. Yeah, safely out to the right. Oh, it's not going to stay. False front there. Connor East Arches group is just teaming off the pole. Now up by the green, Justin Connolly putting for birdie. Pretty lengthy putt. Should be going up the hill. She had to make a birdie today. Breeze began to pick up a little bit, and the clouds are trying to break as well. Could see the sun soon. Robert made par back there at the four. He found the fairway and the green here, and he too has a long putt for birdie. Didn't seem like he was too thrilled after that approach shot. But Justin's got some work left just to avoid back-to-back bogeys. He's had two already in the first four holes today. Don't want to make too many more bogeys, given that this is cut day. All right, JC putting for par here at five. Roberts missed his birdie attempt, so he'll have a par putt forthcoming. Connor's group now in the fairway behind me. Back bogeys now for Justin Connolly. He's three over for the day after five. He's going to need to find some birdie soon. team is shortened par 3, 660 yards, I believe. Pin is on 20 and 7 from the left. Looking through his last four holes, Justin. He's going to hit the ship. On the green, got a good little ways from the hole. Birdie attempt for Justin at 6. That almost pulls a Luke Koenig from yesterday. Par for Justin since the 3rd. We'll stay at 6 over for the championship. Headed to the par 5 7th. Justin on the tee, looks like the 585-yard par 5 7 hole, playing his full length today. 273 to the bunker on the right, 289 over it. Fairway is only about 25 yards wide, and there's a penalty area down the left-hand side, too. Justin's missed a fairway to the left. He's got to be careful here. Make sure he carries that penalty arrow, which runs diagonally between the fairway landing areas. Ooh, and that is set down. At least as a par 5. Justin surveying his options for his 3rd shot, and now the clouds have broken. Plenty of blue sky out here. That wasn't the case about half an hour ago. Yeah, this will start heating up quickly. You see the sun now shining. This is probably not a good lie for Justin. Out of his left rough. Still has to carry this penalty area. Flags back 20 on and 5 from the right. Robert missed the fairway right. He's back in play. Here, traffic from this Ferry Road, which runs behind this green, and runs parallel to the next hole. Our western edge of the property. Still get up and down for par from there. Tough hole coming up, the 8th. Now the 4th with Connelly here at the 7th. First of 2 par 5s. Again, the flag is on 20 and 5 from the right. Don't want to miss right. Walked all the way up to the green. About pin high right. Happy to see if this par. Park front there for Justin. Robert. Bogey park coming up. Good shot on this green to the right. 4.9. Par save to Justin. Stays at plus 6. After another wait on 8, this is Justin off the tee here. I'm guessing it's still 480 today. Could play as long as 500 before this championship is over. Blind tee shot, domestic gray road to the right. Trees to the far right. Domestic gray roads to the left. There's some trees on the left also. Justin's on the right half of the fairway here at the 8th. This is his difficult approach shot. So a hole is located 28 steps on, but 10 steps on the right. That portion of the green slopes from back to front. So he would rather leave this shot below the hole by any means necessary. Came out low, and I didn't see where it finished. Luke had to get up and down here yesterday for par. Go in. Yeah, that's a gimme par. Might feel like a birdie in a way. This is such a hard hole. That would have been some birdie 3. Still looking for his first birdie of the second round. Well, like he said back there in the fairway, the next 3 holes are birdie holes. Park up for Connelly at 8. Justin's on a 380 yard par for 9th hole. One of the few, very few par fours out here to play under 400 yards. I believe it was the 3rd easiest hole in round 1. Par 5 and a drivable par 4 coming up after this hole. Then you got the tough converted par 4 12, which was the 2nd hardest behind the 1st yesterday in the opening round. 2nd shot for Justin here at 9. Went up the hill. Pin is on 13 and 4 from the left. Anything missed left could run off the green. Slopes from right to left. slightly out to the right, but is it on the green? It's hit 5 out of 7 fairways on this side. Alright, birdie putt for Justin at 9. Just to make the turn of 2 over 37. Justin now as he just watched Robert Mize 3-putt for bogey. Not a mental picture you want in your head at this point.
My boy.
So turns in 3 over 38, heads to the par 5 10th. Five of a 50-yard par 5 10th. Trouble on both sides of this fairway. Started on this hole yesterday afternoon. Second shot for Justin here at 10. Is it back in play? In the fairway? We'll see. Looking for his first bird. His two playing partners look like they found a penalty area to the right, including Robert Mize, the 2014 champion. Third shot for Justin Connelly here at 10, par 5. Flag today's on 11, and only 6 from the left. Ooh, that's a little long. It says he needs some circles. Double circles probably wouldn't hurt either. Justin, he's on a similar line to what McKeever just had. This is for birdie. Slightly under it there. Par 5 for Justin. He'll head off to the drive hole. Par 4 11, which gave up 6 eagles yesterday in the opening round. Easiest hole on the golf course. The only hole it played under par.
Drivable for these guys?
Huh? Right, Justin on the tee, the 300 yard par 4, 11. Holes on 15 and 6 on the right today.
Shot.
Ooh, kick left.
Got past all those bunkers here.
Course knowledge.
Course knowledge, exactly.
That's not all it's cracked up to be.
Second shot for Justin Connelly here at 11. If he were to hold this out, he would score an eagle here. Jackson Bishop made eagle here yesterday, one of six. Ooh! And Connelly nearly added to that total. Jackson Bishop started with a double on 10 yesterday, I believe, and came, or might have been triple, and then eagled this hole. And Zach Pritchard chipped in for eagle back in the stroke play portion of the 2017 Atlanta Amateur Match Play Championship. But he didn't have any birdies in his round of 77. The Atlanta Amateur Match Play Championship is now the Georgia Match Play Championship as of 2 years ago. Birdie putt here for the 2017 champion. Are you kidding me? And he still remains birdie free after 11 holes. Three over on his round. 7 holes left. And there is a cut to be made later on. Bounced. That might be on the 11th hole. Well, unfortunately, Justin has problems here at 12. T-shine has found a penalty area. Separates this hole from the previous hole. Hit the cart path and ended up going in. Probably barely have an open shot from down there. The trees to his right. Then don't want to keep the left of the pin today because 14 on 5 from the right. A big bunker right at the green. Short side yourself. Drop is 2, so we'll be playing 3 now. We'll have to get up and down for par. Disappointing pars back there at 10 and 11, especially 11. Just short of the green in one shot. And then he nearly holed out for eagle. just gets it through the tree. Right at it, but short. Unless he can pull that shot out, he's looking at potentially another bogey. At three today through the first 11 and a half holes. Four shots. That's going to be a very tricky right to left breaking putt for his bogey five here at the tough 12th. This hole could play as a par five along with the second hole before this championship is over. Here for Connelly, this should drop him to 7 over. And his first double of the day, now he is 5 over after 12, and 8 over for the week. Might be near or perhaps below the cut line. I haven't looked at the leaderboard yet. And now Connelly on the tee to 375 yard par 413. Fairway bunker about 278. Fine, 302 to fly over. Can't get birdied this hole yesterday. Second shot for Justin at 13. Flags on 17, 6 on the right. Coming out of the left rough. So a little frustration there on that tee shot. So that's after that tee shot. Second shot.
Yo. Stay. Stay.
Jeez. Back to his feet. And the fourth shot.
Go in, buddy. Come on, go in. Woo! Go. Thank you.
Adjust to 13. This would send him down to 9 over. That's 6 over on the day. 5 to play. Looks like the tee has moved up on 14. All of the tees on the par 3s today have been moved up. Yesterday only the 17th was moved up. Just on the tee to 140. Holes on 8 and 4 from the left. Just this tee shot here, the short 14th. It's gone above the hole and has a very slippery putt back down that hill. A birdie. It's running out of holes. Let's get him to 8 over. He's on that putt to stay at plus 9. This is that putt. He's in double digits over par. The finishing stretch is not that easy. He'll have to earn his birdies coming home. 8 putt here in terms of Justin's chances for the weekend, in terms of making a cut. Just needs to go down. Yikes, 10 over par now. 7 over after 14 today. Justin Connelly on the tee at a 440-yard par 4 15th. This was one of the 6 hardest holes yesterday. Unfortunately, he has played his last 3 holes in 4 over. Double bogey bogey. And now he's in double digits for the championship at 10 over. Might have to go all in like James Holzhauer and birdie the last 4 holes. Alright, Justin has split the fairway here at the 15th. It's time for a Connelly comeback. And today 23 on and 5 from the left. Do not want to miss left or long here. Speed is elevated. Trying to work its way back towards the pin. Not a terrible shot. A chance for a birdie. Just a birdie here at 15. Badly needs one. Let's get back in the single digits.
Nice putt, Justin.
Yeah.
first par for Justin since the 11th. Last three holes of the second round coming up. Justin on the 420-yard par from 16. 272 to his bunker on the left, 293 over it. 309 to the first one on the right, 323 to the second one on the right, 331 over the second one on the right. Downhill on the leg left. Front right hole location today at the 16th. Justin has gone down the left side of the fairway here at 16. Second shot to this flag, which is 9 on and 7 on the right. That's been the story of Justin's day. Still no birdies for the first 15 holes today. 7 over on the round, 10 over for the championship. Birdie putt with Justin at 16. It's 34th hole of this championship. At least one or two coming in, if not three. Afternoon waves should be just getting underway with their second group. Jonathan Klotz getting ready to tee off shortly off number 10. Still can't buy a birdie today, Justin Connelly. Nearly had an eagle and a birdie at 11. Downhill par 3 17th coming up, followed by the par 4 18th, which will probably play very difficult in the last two rounds tomorrow and Sunday. .73 yesterday for Justin. If he pars in, he'll shoot 77. All right, so the 2014 champion just made birdie here at 16. Tee shot on the right rough. And Justin, the 2017 champion, putting for par here on the same hole. And he doesn't need pars, he needs birdies. And that's back-to-back pars. So trying to steady the ship. But is it too little too late? On the tier, it's 200 yard par 3 17, 20 yards longer than it played yesterday. The hole today is 30 on and 9 from the right. The other two are already on the green. See it. I don't think he liked it. Just got lucky with that 7-iron. They hit from 212 yards, stayed in bounds. He's got 9 yards of green to work with. Comes down to the putter. This is a VIPP, very important par putt here. Justin Connelly at the 17th. This would be huge. Someone called the police. He just got robbed of that par save. That is 8 over for the round after 17. Puts him in plus 11 for the championship now. He had to hold off his second shot on 18 just to break 80. I'm just not to the 440-yard par for 18. Two throw the bunkers down the right. Penalty areas both left and right also. Narrows to about 28 yards wide between the second bunker and the penalty area on the left. We'll probably play about 480 the next 2 days. Might be in the fairway. Second shot for Justin from the fairway. At 18, pin is on 9 and 6 from the left. You don't want to miss left in that bunker or the penalty area. Looks like at least one player in this group has found the penalty area. If not, both of them, those not named Justin Connelly. If Justin can hold this shot out, he'll shoot 79. Well, no eagle holdout, but if he can make birdie, he'll shoot. Points. Wow, I'm way off track. Actually, he is 8 over for the round after 17. After that latest bogey, birdie would give him a round of 77. So he should break 80. But the question is, will he be around for the final 36? Last chance for birdie for Justin. This is at the last, the 36th hole of the championship. It'll be a birdie-free second round for Justin Connelly. That par putt remaining for a round of 8 over 78. Par is 70 the first two rounds. I had par 72 on the brain earlier when I was talking about trying to break 80. Alright, Mr. Connelly now for par at the 18th and a round of 8 over par 78, which would put him at 11 over 151, and then he's probably going to have to sit and wait it out as far as whether or not he'll be playing tomorrow and Sunday or going home tonight. And that's assuming the weather behaves the rest of this day, which unfortunately was not the case yesterday. Actually, it's Robert's turn Hey, did I miss something?